This is the ViewSonic XG3240C. A bit of a long name and it's a bit of a code, but we'll decipher it in this video and we'll also find out if I'd be willing to put this monitor on my desk or whether it's even worth your money. Let's take a look. So let's start with the name. Let's decipher that. The XG means that it's part of its gaming, ViewSonic's gaming range. The 32 means that it's a 32-inch monitor. The 40 is kind of part of their kind of model delineation, but it also means that it's the 1440p variety, and the C stands for curved. This is an 1800R kind of curved monitor, and it's pretty interesting. So let's take a look. Now the panel itself, as I said, is a 2560 by 1440 VA panel. It is curved, as I said, that 1800R radius, and it is actually a pretty decent overall panel. The sort of gaming use for it, which is the intended use case since it's part of their XG lineup, was actually really good, although I'll come into that more in a second, but especially even things like viewing angles on the panel were actually pretty impressive from both side to side and top, so that's always nice to see. Now, of course, the monitor itself has a pretty good amount of sort of adjustability and maneuverability to it. You have height adjust, you also have tilt and swivel, and you also have rotation of the panel, although I'd mention that the stand itself doesn't actually seem to be tall enough to fully support the monitor in its rotated format, so just bear that in mind if you do want to run this rather kind of weird curved monitor in a portrait mode, which kind of curves away from you and then back to you, but either way, it's a pretty cool and pretty maneuverable monitor. In terms of display inputs for the monitor, you have display ports as well as two HDMI, and these support HDR10, so if you do fancy using that, that is available here. You'd also have some audio pass-throughs and a USB 3 hub with the downlink port on the sort of right-hand side, with then a couple of extra ports in the sort of grooved carbon fiber looking sort of slots in the side as well. The overall aesthetic of the monitor, including on the back, is pretty nice. It's relatively subtle. It's not too, you know, in-your-face gamery. There's no RGB lights or lasers that shine up on the ceiling like some of the new Asus monitors, but it does a decent job of being relatively gamery but not too insane. The base does have a lot of glossy plastic on it and is a relatively large footprint, so be aware that that's gonna, you know, take up a lot of space on your desk, but otherwise is a pretty sturdy and overall decent mount and base. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's take a look at the, you know, actual gaming experience. This, as I said, is a 2560 by 1440, 144Hz, and also a FreeSync compatible monitor, so if you have an RX 580 or a Vega 56 or a Vega 64, this is going to be a fantastic gaming monitor for you. The curve isn't something that I care about that much. I'd be equally as happy playing on a flat panel 32-inch 2560 monitor, but the pixel density is actually pretty great on these, and also even with that 144Hz refresh rate, it's really smooth and very nice to game on. I could see this being used in content production if you wanted to. It's a decent size for playing back content, but of course, the curve does make it a little bit difficult to understand how most people would be viewing your content, so just bear that one in mind. And being a VA panel, it's not going to be the most accurate. It's obviously, while it does support HDR, it doesn't necessarily have the most accurate color reproduction as well, so this might not be the perfect monitor for color sensitive work, but again, it's kind of branded in the gaming category, and for that, it does its job very well. I think overall, if you pick up this monitor, you'd be pretty happy with it. The pricing that's currently on Amazon, for example, is actually pretty good compared to the Acer and Asus competitor monitors, with the Acer one being about £50 more and the Asus one being about £100 more, putting this at a pretty decent value proposition, at least for the FreeSync kind of side of the market. So would I put this on my desk? Well, for me, it's a little bit too big. The 32 inches, while still holding a pretty nice pixel density with that 2560 by 1440 resolution, it's not for me personally, but I'd be more than happy to recommend it to any of you, especially if you do prefer a little bit of a bigger display than the average 1440p display, as that one's more the sort of 27-inch model, but it is very nice. The curve isn't something that I care too much about, and if you found a flat panel version of this, for example, you might have a potentially better experience depending on what you prefer, but it certainly doesn't detract from the experience at all, and I'm overall pretty happy with it. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Is this a monitor that you're going to be picking up next week, or is this something that is kind of your dream, or you hate the curve? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. If you want to check out the monitor, feel free to do so in the link in the description, and there's a whole load of links in the description down below where you can use to support the channel, including Amazon affiliate links, which you should probably know how to use by now, but just feel free to click them when you're buying stuff. stuff on Amazon, and it massively helps me out. If you're new to the channel, feel free to hit the subscribe button as well as the notification icon. There are some other videos over here for you on the very far side of this monitor, and otherwise that's pretty much it. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments down below and I will try and get back to you as soon as I can. And otherwise, thank you for watching and we'll see you all in the next video.